Welcome to Wall Street Mojo. To know about this video, CORREL Excel Function, that's correlation. Watch the video till the end. If you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Today we have a topic with us is the correlation function. We have heard this topic when we talk about statistics. This is a sort of a statistics, not a sort of, it is a statistical function. CORREL function is categorized as a statistical function in Excel, and the correlation formula in Excel is used to find out the correlation between the correlation coefficient between the two variables. That's the whole idea behind this. It returns the correlation coefficient between array 1 and array 2. And you can use the correlation coefficient to determine the relationship between the two properties. For example, the correlation between the particular stock and the market index, how does that go? Well, you just write correlation, array 1 and 2. So correlation formula in Excel has two compulsory parameters, that is array 1 and 2. Array 1, it is required set of independent variables. And then there is array 2, which is, it is a set of dependent variable. Well, wherein are the sample means and calculated by the average. So if the value of the correlation, if your R, if it is closer to 1, then it indicates it is a strong positive correlation. If it is, if your R is minus 1 or closer to minus 1, it shows a strong negative correlation. These are the two terms. Now, how to use a correlation function in Excel? Very important. See, correlation function in Excel is very simple and easy to use. Let's understand the working of the correlation by some examples. And before that, if this is equal to 0, then in that scenario, there is no correlation. So we have data 1 and data 2. In this first example, let's consider two set, 1 and 2 data, as shown in the below tables. We will simply use the formula here is equal to correlation, CORREL, and this is the array number 1. And this one is array number 2. We have the correlation as 0.66. Let's do for the example number 2 here. Now, there is a stock A change in S&P 5 weekly change data is given. So in this example, we consider data set of weekly change for a stock A as data 1 and S&P 500 weekly changes as data 2 shown in the table. Now calculate the correlation coefficient function using the CORREL and output will be, let's calculate that. This is, and the second one, so you have 0.8901152 as the answer. Let's go with example number 3, x and y values. In this example, we are taking a perfect positive correlation. For example, considering a variable x value increases with the value of the variable, and value of the variable x decreases with the value of the variable y decreases. How does it happen? CORREL, first one, comma, second one. That gives us 1. So that is increase and decrease are matching. Here we consider an example number 4. We consider an example of a perfect negative correlation. And as the value of the variable x increases, when the value of the variable z decreases and the value of the variable x decreases, the value of the variable z also increases. How does it happen? As simple as that. Let's do that. This is just an opposite scenario that we are trying to look at. This is the first array, second one, And that's why it is minus 1. So the CORREL function Excel can be used as VBA function also. That can also be done. Now there are a couple of things to remember. First, there is a thing called the NA error in correlation. So correlation function Excel through the NA error if the given arrays are of different lengths. Means if array number 1 and 2 if contains different numbers of data points, like CORREL will return to the NA error value. Then we have the div 0 error. At the correlation function Excel to the div 0 error, if either of the given array 1 or 2 are empty, or if the Excel standard deviation SD of the value are equal to 0. So if the supplied array or references or the argument contains a text or a string, then in that particular scenario, or logical values or empty values, then those values are ignored automatically. So the CORREL function in Excel includes the value 0 in its calculation. So if you have learned and enjoyed watching the video, do not forget to comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you.